Welcome, Human Resource and Organization Development Professionals. Today, you'll see the second part of my interview with Sean Copeland, President and CEO of Regent Bank. Sean is a real leader of culture, and Regent Bank was recognized as one of only two Oklahoma businesses with Inc. magazine's Great Places to Work. I encourage you, if you haven't seen the first video yet, to view that. But once you do, sit back and enjoy today's continuation of my interview with Sean Copeland.
So strong culture is based, some would even say that culture and leadership are two sides of the same coin. If you have strong leaders, you will have strong culture. You can't have strong culture without strong leadership. So how do you, are there things in particular you do to nurture your team, your leaders, so that they are living your message and taking it out? What any particular strategy?
Mm-hmm. You know, my belief is that a leader can't necessarily make a culture or an organization, but you can definitely ruin it. Okay. So I believe that we just happen to have an organization of really, really caring and kind people. I didn't make them that way, but we try to not allow people that are not that way to stay. Okay. So that's a big one. Being very clear on our expectations, I think, is very important. Mm-hmm. I meet with my executive team on a regular basis, and we always review the core values. We rank each other on the core values as part of our review process. Okay. So it's literally on the review, and I rank you 1 to 5 on how I think you're doing in these particular areas. And if you're not a 5, here's why. You know, we hire for them. It's just everything we do. We open our employee meetings with them. So we really, really, our core values are, and I always say, you cannot work here if you don't follow the core values. I don't care what level of the organization that you're in. So that's a big one. Another big one is I meet with every new employee after they've worked here 90 days, which is getting a lot harder because we are hiring a lot of people.
You just said every new employee. How many employees?
Every 100. We've got 100 employees. We've hired 25 this year. So every one of them, when they hit their 90 days, and I say I meet with them. If they're far away, we visit via phone or do video conferences.
Are in communication with each employee.
Yeah, and I ask them, all of them, two questions. One is, are we who we said we were when we hired you?
Wow.
So we said we're all this great culture, blah, blah, blah. Are we really? Please be honest with me. And if we're not, where do we make adjustments? And two, what can we do better? Because most of them came from great organizations and they're 90 days in. They kind of see how we do things. A lot of our best ideas have come out of those meetings where people realized, you know, well, there are some things that you guys do that are kind of weird, you know. And so, yeah, that I think that's been very helpful as
that
well.
The idea of innovation, when people are in an organization for a certain length of time, it only is so long and actually shorter than most people realize before they're now enculturated and they no longer see the organization with fresh eyes.
Yes.
So to capture that at 90 days, that's a great piece to structure in. Good for you.
That's why we do that at 90 days, because I think if they stay much longer, I'm sure I stole this from somebody. I don't think this was my original idea. I just don't remember who I stole it from. But if they stay much longer, they've drank the Kool-Aid and mm-hmm. they think we're the greatest thing ever. And so, it's pretty wild some of the stuff you get.
Excellent. So, because I want to keep this at a time when actually our watchers will actually keep watching. Right. Might have to break this up into two. We'll see. So let me skip down to... Actually, I've got two more. I'm going to push you for two more. So what inspires you as a leader? Where do you draw from? What well do you drink in?
Yeah, I read or listen to a book a week. And so I'm constantly trying to stay fresh and learn. I have an excellent group through Young Presidents Organization, where a forum group, there's seven of us that are all CEOs. We learn from each other. I have a bank study group that are CEOs from all through the mid part of the country that we learn from each other more on an industry basis. I go through leadership training myself a lot to try to stay sharp. I just think you've always got to be learning, you know, because it's really, really, really easy to get into a rut. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I'm the one that kind of needs to be on the forefront of our growth. And so I just feel like that's a very important part of my job.
And with your one of your core values being lifelong learning, is that correct?
Yes.
So you've got to lead that charge.
Correct.
Yes. Okay, very good. So I've got one last question. Because the principle, actually, the reason we're doing this particular topic, many people know that they need mission and values and they need to articulate it. And yet there's often such a gap mm-hmm. between what's on the wall and what's lived and what employees and therefore customers experience. So you've got a CEO sitting on the other side. You've got 2 minutes to talk to her and share with her, here's what you need to do. If you're going to strengthen culture, you should. How would you finish that?
Yeah, so I would say, first and foremost, you have to have a real set of core values. And the way that we created ours was we looked at our best employees. And we said, okay, what is it about them that made them so excellent? And that's where we came up with our core values. Then I think you just have to integrate it into the organization. I mentioned this just a little bit earlier, but I think it's got to be in hiring. When we interview somebody, these are our core values. Are you comfortable with these? How do you feel about these? You know, mm-hmm. blah, blah, blah. What do they say uh-huh. to you when you come on board? As part of the onboarding, we're talking core values. As part of your ongoing one-on-ones, we're talking core values. As part of your review, we're talking core values. I mean, it's just in the employee meeting, we're talking core values. I mean, it's just a constant, it's with us all day long. And I think the biggie is you have to, your executive team, you have to stack hands around these core values. And it's gotta be, okay, here's what we're gonna do. Everybody, let's all agree that we're going to give everybody, including the people around this table, one warning. And if they cannot follow these values, they cannot work here. And I think that was the biggie. When we literally, as a team, stood, and we're not this kind of a touchy-feely, you know, kumbaya group. I mean, we literally stacked our hands on each other and said, we promise, we commit. And we got to hold each other accountable if we feel like somebody's sliding. But I think that's how you integrate it with the organization. And one final thing I would say is you got to stick to those whether you're making money or not. So what happens a lot of times is when times are good, man, we're culture kings and we're all culture, culture, culture. And then when times don't look that great, forget culture. We're just trying to survive. You cannot do that. It's got to be something that you live all the time, whether or not you're at the top of the hill or down in the valley. So.
That is gold for folks. So thank you, Sean Copeland. It is a pleasure talking with you today. If you are in Missouri and you are looking for a bank in Springfield, please look for Regent Bank.
Or Tulsa.
Or Tulsa.
Or Nowata, Oklahoma.
That's right. That's right. Thanks so much and look forward to talking with you in future videos.
And I trust you got a lot out of the interview with Sean Copeland. If your organization needs some assistance in either part of that culture work, first of all, getting clearer on the cultural imperatives, your mission, your vision, your values. If those are not done, they haven't been looked at in years, or they're just hanging up on a wall somewhere, I'd love to help you think about them and craft them in a way that makes them real for your people. The second part of that, of course, is leadership. Sometimes you have the right mission, you have the right values, but you haven't yet developed the people to be your culture bearers. If you'd like assistance, we can talk with you about that. Please reach out at your convenience. Thanks so much. I look forward to seeing you next week.